up guys and welcome back to the channel. Today we actually have something really, really interesting and confirmation that the leak about the Colin Trevorrow script was in fact completely true. And the Colin Trevorrow Star Wars Episode 9 leaked details, again, are all true. We know this because today concept art was released for Colin Trevorrow's Episode 9 entitled Duel of Fates, which would have given us a far more different take on Star Wars 9. Anyway though guys, let's go ahead and jump into it and discuss the various concept art images we get, as well as some story details about Colin Trevorrow's Episode 9. A lot of the final act of the Duel of Fates was actually set to take place on the world of Coruscant, where the First Order was going to inhabit after the events of The Last Jedi, and the Resistance was going to attempt to infiltrate and then start an uprising. The first piece of concept art we get is actually of an older Leia in BB-8. Leia here is wearing the robes very similar to what she wore in A New Hope, and appears to be giving BB-8 a data tape just as she did with R2-D2 in the original Star Wars. Following this is a piece of concept art with the Force Ghost Luke Skywalker training Rey. We see here Rey is wearing an outfit very similar to what Luke wore in Return of the Jedi, and it is interesting that in this iteration, instead of Leia being Rey's master, it was actually Luke, and that Luke returned as a Force Ghost to train Rey. After this, in the next piece of art, we get a far better look at Rey's costume for this Duel of Fates version, where we see that the lightsaber that she was going to have would be a double-bladed blue lightsaber, using her original staff and the Skywalker lightsaber, and modifying them together, kind of similar to what we got at the end of The Rise of Skywalker, where she actually changed her staff into a lightsaber. But again, this one is really different. Of course, behind her, we see a group of dead stormtroopers. After this is an image of the occupation of Coruscant, with these AT-ST walkers being recuperated and built for the uprising. It appears as if again the AT-STs have been made for the uprising, while the First Order has more advanced machinery, and you can see the stormtroopers marching against what appears to be this resistance. After this is another image of this uprising. What's interesting though is it appears as if a lot of the common folk in the galaxy are actually wearing old stormtrooper armor, or at least some type of white uniforms. We then get another concept art image of the battle with Finn, as well as more stuff with these converted AT-ST walkers, which I personally think look really cool. As you can see in this concept art image, the Resistance working on modifying them, as well as in the next piece, a Super Star Destroyer of the First Order era appearing to have occupied the world of Coruscant, which is a really cool image actually. And you can see that the ship and the world of Coruscant are actually connected here. An interesting little touch in my opinion. And it does make sense that the First Order would want to flee to the world of Coruscant after their victory in The Last Jedi, and after a lot of the Resistance was wiped out. The next piece of concept art is of C-3PO and R2-D2 walking through the barren streets of again Coruscant, as you can even see the ship in the background, as well as the apparent death of R2-D2 in the final battle of Duel of Fates. However, at the end of the leaked script, R2-D2 was going to be repaired by Chewbacca. And then finally, we get a look at the lightsaber duel between Rey and Kylo Ren on Mortis, where in the plot, Kylo Ren was essentially attempting to become a Force God and a Force deity, similar to an individual like the Sun from the Clone Wars, which is why he ventures to Mortis. We also see here he has a different helmet that he wore in The Last Jedi, as well as in The Force Awakens, and it was described in the leaked script to be Mandalorian in nature, and made out of Beskar. He was also going to wear it because he was going to have sustained some real major injuries in Duel of Fate, including a holocron exploding right in his face. Speaking of Kylo Ren, the next image we get is of Kylo Ren dueling Darth Vader within a dark side cave. In this sequence, Kylo Ren would be under the tutelage of a new master known as Tor Valum, a Lovecraftian creature that is also explained to have also taught Palpatine in the ways of the dark side of the Force. And similarly to how Luke Skywalker battled the vision of Darth Vader within the dark side cave, Kylo Ren was going to here. Here though, Kylo Ren was going to lose, and exit the cave extremely frustrated, killing his new master. After this is actually my favorite piece of concept art. It's a Force Ghost Luke Skywalker actually grabbing the blade of Kylo Ren, which would of course been a brand new Force ability that we've never seen before, especially impressive coming from a Force Ghost. And then finally, the last piece of concept art is General Hux killing himself with a lightsaber on the world of Coruscant, as we heard he was going to do after the Rebellion or the Resistance defeat the First Order. It was also going to be revealed that General Hux wanted to be a Force wielder and collected lightsabers, and that he was always jealous of Kylo Ren, in the end though using one of the lightsabers to commit suicide. Anyway guys, that's all the new concept art that we got from the Duel of Fates, and again, this is confirmation that the script was 100% true. Comparing the stories, I must be honest, I do like what we got in The Rise of Skywalker more, but I do think the concept art is compelling. Anyway, my friends, what are your thoughts on this concept art from Duel of Fates? And what do you think it would have looked like if we got Colin Trevorrow's episode 9? As always, my friends, thank you so much for watching. May the Force be with you, and have a great day. Thank you.